What's going on, guys? It's Random Pickups, year two. Shit. Couldn't do that and be cool. I just couldn't do that intro and be cool and not cough my ass off from that dab. So, who cares? Spycat doesn't like editing and cutting stuff, so who gives a crap? Anyway, guys. Wow, that was a long brain pause right there. Anyway, guys, year two, episode 21. I went out to Amoeba and Rasputin in San Francisco. And after watching all these, like, horror videos on YouTube, People's Collection and stuff, the uppity Negron Akan or whatever his name is. I don't know how to say his name. But uppity Negron Makan or something like that. Something like that. Wow. This guy's awesome. He only has 5 videos on his channel, but he blows everybody's horror collection off the map. Just because, like, every movie is just some... He doesn't show, like, the common titles that are in the movie theaters. He's showing all those out-of-print ones, his whole collection. Oh, man. But his whole horror collection covers, like, five different videos from A to Z of his horror collection. It is amazing. Nobody beats this guy, in my opinion. You know, the other guys, they're too much of a on the, like, Blu-ray hype. And it's true, you know, people are hyping up the Blu-ray thing. And it's like, I'm fine with the DVDs. I like VHS old school horror. So DVD is a freaking enough for me. That freaking rhymed. Anyway, like I said, I only get, like, Blu-rays if it's, like, a good deal. I'm not really about the whole hype of the Blu-rays. I like the size of the DVDs. I like the paper, if it comes with the paper and the cover and all that crap. I just like DVDs. I'm a DVD collector. But anyway, year two, episode 21, I went out to Rasputin and Amoeba today. Spent a little bit of money. I went out there with money I was supposed to save for the week for me eating at work. And I couldn't resist that horror section, guys. I strictly went in the horror sections and the VHS section. 25-cent VHS at our Rasputin. And I got some cool VHS tapes, but this is definitely a horror movie video, which is really cool because I got some out-of-print stuff, anchor-based stuff. Rasputin doesn't really, they don't really care about putting that out-of-print, marking it up a high price unless it's like Disney Treasures or something like that. So, you know, I'm able to like kind of look and type in, see what's out-of-print and stuff, and get those horror movies. But I did get an out-of-print one at Amoeba, but I paid $14.99 for it. And you know what? That's the first one up. Old school, a younger Jodie Foster. In 1976, out of print movie, I paid $14.99 for this thing. The Little Girl Who Lives Down the Lane. I have to have this in my horror movie collection. You just have to have this one. It's younger Jodie Foster in a horror movie. I mean, it's absolutely great. Let's see. So that one I paid $14.99 for. That was the highest one that I paid the most for. That is pretty much sells for that used on eBay and stuff. So, you know, whatever. And like I said, I'm strictly a hunter. I'm making this known. I'm strictly a hunter. There's two things that I want that I might have to get on eBay at some point. And I want to do this. I want to get the Unsolved Mysteries Miracles, the highest price one. You can, like, $100 to $225 on eBay. You can get that 4-pack used for. So, that's the only thing I would buy on eBay. And, Timothy Treadwell's Grizzly Man Diaries, when they had, like, I think they had, like, 7 episodes on the Discovery Channel, and it was released on DVD, like, 10 years ago or something. I hope I can still find that thing. That's so only two things that just you're never going to see in the when you're hunting at Amoeba and Rasputin. Because I'm a hunter. I'm not one of these, you know, guys who, you know, there's movie stores. I'm going to go to the movie stores because I have a love for hunting and searching and going to movie stores and looking at those titles. That's what I love to do. So they're not going to make me hunt them on the computer. I'm not going to be a robot because they're saying to be a robot and live like that. And you're inside. It's like... When they take all the movie stores away, Spycat will be around with his collection and crap like that. I seriously did not talk for 5 minutes. Hopefully you guys stuck in there. Let's go, because I have good pile of movies. $140 blown. And check out this out-of-print movie right here that sells, I think, for like $40-$30 on eBay. Hold on, we'll see. So, okay, so it looks like one sold for $40. Can you see that? See that thing? $40. And then there's a few that are like $20, $20. So it's about $20. I paid $11.95 for it at Rasputin, and it's in great shape, and I love how it's not like the just one disc that's like on both sides of each movie. I love that it's actually the real, and these things were in great condition. You know, it's got that original thing. That is awesome. Wish it came with a booklet, but these don't come with booklets. But this is cool to finally have this. You know, this at Amiibo would sell for, I think, like $29.99, I think I saw it for, because they know it's out of print, or $39.99 or something. But Rasputin wasn't up on that, and it was only $11.95. So that is cool. Got another out-of-print one. This one's probably exactly what I bought it for. $9.95 at Rasputin. Here it is. Rage 2, Carrie, The Rage, Carrie Part 2, which is a great movie. Love this movie right here. The last of the 90s movies. Of course it is, because it's 99. But, yeah. Have to have that in the collection. I don't know why I sold my copy. We got a movie I was looking for, a movie I wanted. This is a re-release, though. I wish I had the original Anchor Bay one. But this is just going to do... this is a newer release of Anchor Bay. But I wish I had that original one of this. It's The Entity. Have to have that. Gotta have that. Yeah. That's what I was doing. I was watching that guy. And then you see their collection. You're like, man, I gotta have that one. It's kind of cool. I got a couple $7.95 ones. So, yeah, that was $7.97 at Rasputin, and these were $7.95 used. Mirror Mirror 2, an Anchor Bay movie right here. Mirror Mirror 2, Raven Dance. This is a movie you don't even hear about or see anymore. Nobody talks about it. I love it. It's actually a 90s one, 93. Pretty cool. This is about a crazy mirror. Look at this. A mysterious mirror is found hidden in a church orphanage, yet few realize its legacy of evil. So that is pretty cool right there. I want to watch this thing. And let's see what it's worth. So yeah, it looks like shit. I didn't even realize that. There's like new ones selling for $40. It is one of those harder DVD Anchor Bay DVDs to find. Let's see what some sell for. Done, you bastard. Let's see. Why is it doing this shit? What's going on here? Still trying to figure this out. Okay, fuck that. Who cares? But I do want to check out this other one. You guys know Spy Cat. This is just how the video is going to be. Got another Anchor Bay one for $7.95 used, out of print, the card player. I think this is like worth what I got it for though. Anchor Bay one. I'm going to have to show off that it has a booklet in there. That's why I love DVDs. Blu-rays ain't doing these booklets and crap. Pretty cool. No pictures though it looks, but it's still a booklet. Pretty cool. This thing's awesome. Add to the Anchor Bay out of print one. Pretty cool. It does come with that original cover. Freaking awesome. A little bit dented, as you could see, though. But, you know, whatever. I'm a hunter. I'm not going to see this movie again. Yeah, so that's cool. That's the more expensive ones I got. And I finally found this crap. The Killing Room, the Saw movies. What are those? Movies like this, where it's like six guys and they're like, one guy's messing with them, they're playing a game, last guy standing wins the money or whatever. I saw this movie on the computer and it was always in my head to It was like 5 years. I saw it like 5 years ago, and I couldn't think of the name of this thing. Die. This is what I was looking for. This is a cool movie. They're rolling the dice. That's how many bullets they have to do Russian roulette with each other, and other like crazy games by this killing sicko freak dude that kidnaps like probably five people. Now, let's just see what it says. Six people, each on the road of self-destruction, waking up trapped in a surreal facility without knowing how they got there or why. Held captive by a mysterious man, the abductees are subjected to the trials, a sadistic experiment in which they're forced to decide each other's faith over a nerve-wracking game of dice. Pretty cool. Love movies like this. This one you do not see that often. In the Bay Area. LA, man. I wish I lived there and got to see that amoeba and Rasputin. Got another out-of-print one, the original one, because you know they re-release it by like, and then it's not worth it. You need the Artisan and the Republic Pictures, which is both on this logo right here. Golden Years, Stephen King's Golden Years, even came with the paper and everything. Great condition. Love these Republic Pictures one. Same as the Rumpelstiltskin one it was at. But this is great. One of the last Stephen King's 80s, 90s movies I needed in my collection to complete it all. So this was $5.95, and Dice was $5.95. This next pile is all $5.95ers from Rasputin. Finally got The Gate, the 1987 movie right here from my childhood. Awesome, awesome movie right here. Had to get that. I was looking for that one. Because you know my main thing's 90s and 80s and stuff. Look at this out of print one right here. I didn't look this one up. I'm too lazy to. Something you don't see in the stores too often. Prom Night 3, The Last Kiss. Prom Night 4, Deliver Us From Evil. Artisan release. Pretty cool right there. Look at that. Got that in my collection. Just need to clean the outside of the cover. It's got the original paper. Pretty cool. These things you don't see too often in the stores if you're a hunter. Vampires Out for Blood with Matt Dillon's brother and shit. The B actor guy, Kevin Dillon. Vampires is another 90s movie, I think, from no, this is 2003. But yeah, love this. Crazy stuff going on there, man. It's even got a booklet. Look at that. Pretty cool. Awesomeness. Screen media. I remember these early 2000s. Like the Dice movie. This is another one, kind of like that, from Dimension Pictures. Dimension Extreme. Steel Trap. Another one. This one I didn't see, or maybe I did, I can't remember. But I love these type of movies. I will be doing a video on my collection of movies like that, where people get kidnapped, like Saw movies and Hostel, maybe. Hostel would have to go in there. This one movie's not a horror movie. $5.95. Got it in Drama. Another 90s movie. I think 93. But it's Racer Flyer from 1992. I'm a 90s person. This is my childhood. That's why I have to get this. Classic, man. About, and the guy from Home Alone's in it. Elijah Wood. I mean, come on. Inspired by a local legend, they attempt to build a working airplane. And in the process of transforming their ordinary red wagon into a fantastical flying machine. Pretty cool. If you haven't seen this one in your childhood, it's great. Okay. $4.99. Yeah. So these last two movies I paid $4.99 for at Amoeba. Got a few movies at Amoeba. Some Kind of Hate. This is bully revenge right here, man. Relentless bullying has turned Lincoln's life into a nightmare. But soon he learns the true meaning of terror when he is sent to remote school for troubled teens, and their harassments start all over again. Only this time someone is watching a teenage girl named Mora or some shit, who was driven to suicide by vicious bullying years ago. Man, I'm stoned. When Lincoln accidentally summons her from the grave, he unleashes a vengeful and unstoppable force on a mission of blood-soaked revenge. Maybe she's like helping him out with his bullies and shit. That'd be pretty cool. And I like how it has the kind of cool like advertisements on this. I like when they do that. That's cool. You know, don't waste the space on a DVD. Hate when they do that. And I hate the holes in the fucking DVDs. We'll probably come across one of those. Check this out. From Amoeba, this is something I'd never seen. I couldn't even find this on eBay. Crazy. Reign of Fear. Mel Gibson movie. I mean, just when you thought you knew all the Mel Gibson movies he ever made. I thought I did, but look at this. Crazy movie. Pretty cool. And this next pile is $3.95ers. Psycho 2, the original one, by Image. No, Good Times. Pretty cool. Awesome to have that. Dusk Till Dawn, because I have part one. Have to get part two. Part three, probably worse. This movie was $7.95, but I talked him into $3.95 because it was kind of scratch, but you just never see this movie. I love movies like this. Black Water. About look at that. They're on this tree, or you know, they're in the middle. Somehow they get stuck in the middle of like this swamp, and this alligator's you know trying to eat them as soon as they mess up or something. I love movies like this. Love movies like that. A Deadly Story of the Most Terrifying Fight to Survive. Awesome, man. Look at this shit. This is my type of shit. That's freaking awesome. It doesn't even look like an alligator. Oh yeah, it does. Awesomeness right there, man. Look at that. They're on the tree. The fucking alligator's there. Fuck. Old blockbuster movie here called The Rage, put out by Screen Media Films. They did like horror movies in the early like 2000s, kind of late. Pretty crazy. This movie looks pretty crazy. These people get like escape. When this guy's turning them into these mutants or something, I don't know. Blessed with Heather Graham, some, you know, some. They want her baby, you know, this type of crap. But it looks pretty cool. From, I think, 2004. Here's a sci-fi movie. These movies I got at Amoeba for $2.99. Those were $3.95ers. Gattaca, needed this for my collection. I heard this is out of print on eBay. It's marked as out of print. So pretty cool. I needed this for my collection. Even has the booklet. Pretty cool. And out of print, I already have volume two, or maybe it's just volume two. Denver, The Last Dinosaur. I have volume two, so I had to get volume one. 10 episodes. Old school. Old school 90s, 80s, man. Orphan was only $1.99 at Amoeba. That's a good deal. Great deal. Have to get Orphan. And I might have this movie, but I just got it for the case. It was in the dollar bin. Mark Ruffalo, I like his movies. So I tried to buy this. I hope I don't have it. If I do, it's cool because this is a one of those heavy, cool, old school cases, man. Pretty cool. Only $1.99. For only a dollar. Meg Ryan, Omar Epps. Whatever. You know, Against the Rope. It's just so dumb, it's you have to watch it. Two great actors. Now I'll show you the VHS crap. Old school covers right here. Look at this one. I've never seen this one. Martians Go Home. I mean, come on, sci-fi fans. Pretty cool, man. This is awesome. It's awesome. Awesomeness is going on right here with fucking Randy Quaid. Pretty cool, man. 1 billion green comedians have just landed on Earth. Now the joke is on us. What kind of crazy crap? I've never heard of this crap. This is awesome. Awesome. Look at this original right here. This is what I remember in the movie stores. Oh, man. Mac and fucking me. Original cover. DVD ain't like that. DVD is not that sweet. But that is an original cover. Yeah, it's a little beat up, but it's even heavy. That's cool. How'd you get that? And this is just for the original cover. I don't even like this movie, never even seen it. But for a quarter, it's like, eventually when I make a cool, like, cooler room, having the covers of stuff all around is cool. This movie sells for, I think, $50 at Amoeba on the DVD, so I had to pick it up on a VHS because it's probably worth money. Exit of Eden to Eden. Pretty cool. It's a hard movie to find. For some reason, that's a hard movie to find. It's out of print. I got Cops. Have to collect these old school tapes from my childhood and all that. Originals. Love that. For a quarter. And here's a movie I am an idiot. I sold it on DVD. The Snapback. I'm an idiot to sell that. But this is in 99% great condition. I have a beat up one that I bought for like $2. But, this is in perfect condition. The case is outstanding. I got really lucky on Curly Sue. That's how I watched it when I rented it a dozen times when I was a kid. This was a quarter, even though it says that. I'll pick that off. Original. Back to School. Original. Love the originals just for the cover, just for the classic movie. Look at that old school TriStar fucking logo. From the VHS days. Meatballs Part 2 even gave me a case, plastic case. Awesomeness right here, man. Awesomeness. And original, the DVD doesn't have that whole thing. The DVD only has like this, the Tom Selleck. But this is like you get the whole cover. So I love that about the VHS. And Blu-ray is just the worst of it. Then it gives you a third of the poster. Fucking assholes. That's why I love the DVDs. At least they kept some of the originals, most of them. Original covers. Fatal Beauty. I've never seen this even on DVD at the stores. Whoopi Goldberg. Your Younger Days. Look at this. Man, you could tell I love the 80s and 90s. She's Out of Control. Movie you never see on DVD. I don't know if this was even on DVD. Tony freaking Danza, man. This is awesome. Awesomeness right there going on with Tony freaking Danza. Let's see. Bounty Hunter is just another 90s movie. You don't see this too often. Blockbuster movie. Action one. I love like those ones. This one sells for $5.99 at Amoeba, but it was at Rasputin for a quarter. The Road to Hong Kong. Love these classic ones, man. Gotta have these. Had to get one of those. Flight with Dean Cain. This movie ain't on DVD. Not that I know of. Pretty cool, man. This is looks like some awesomeness. This one's out of print. Unlawful Entry, original. Nice. Kind of a thriller action. Two clamshells for a 25 cents. Napoleon right there going on. Look at that freaking dog. Look at that freaking dog. MGM released this movie. I never heard of it, but it looks pretty cool. I love collecting these kids ones with especially dogs. This is awesome. For a freaking quarter. In the package. Disney's 25th anniversary presents Schoolhouse Rock. You know what? That's random pickups.